Hey guys, today I'm going to be trying to make this flour ham roll maker. And it looks pretty simple, but who knows? You know how I like to mess things up. So, to make this flour ham roll, you're going to need bread. You are going to need ham. And you are going to need cheese. And it doesn't have to be ham, it can be other lunch meats. And if you can't eat cheese, you don't have to put cheese in. Be flexible, guys. So you're going to take your piece of bread and put it on a plate and microwave it for 20 seconds. And this is a 6-slice piece of bread. I don't know if you guys count bread like that in other countries, but I would suggest using an 8-slice loaf of bread just because I think it would be easier to cut through with the cutter. But the store I went to only had 6-slice, so we're using 6-slice today. And I'm gonna go microwave this. Our bread is back from the microwave and we are going to place cheese and ham on it now. Right here in the middle, and a piece of ham right over it. Then we're going to take our ham sandwich cutter thingy and line it up with the ham and press down. I'm going to pull the outside bread away. And don't worry, this will be eaten too. So we'll take the non-pointy end of the toothpick and just push this guy out of here. Push gently because you don't want to poke a hole. And then, time for the magic. You're going to take from the middle and wind it tightly. Kind of so it lays on top of it. Ta-da! So, here is your rose sandwich. I don't know if it's supposed to be that fat. I think it's because of the bread. But then this goes into the toaster, and I will attempt to make a prettier one. Ta-da! So my second one turned out a little bit better. I think the point is to cut the bread while it's still warm, so you have to move pretty fast. Ta-da! So here is the toasted version with the melty cheese, and here's the non-toasted version. I personally am not a big fan of toasted bread, but I think in this case both will be very, very yummy. I have kind of a secret slash confession kind of information. I try not to watch other YouTubers' videos when they make the same things, so I can keep originality for my own video and not copy them and stuff if they do, you know, some special kind of technique thing. I try to do it, you know, all originally me. I'm sure some of you will understand, but I did watch a video on someone making this, and they actually made one with just the bread and put colored sugar on top, and it was beautiful, and their ham roll looked beautiful too, so you'll have to check them out. I don't remember their username, but I'm sure if you look up ham cheese roll, what is it called? Flour ham roll, that you'll find it. And if you guys know, you can post the username down below. But anyways, so I did watch that person's, and I know that mine is not as good as theirs, but I did try my best, and I'm sure it's going to taste just fine. So I'm going to taste the toasted one, and let you know. In this case, the toasted one may be better. This melted cheese is really good. So, for a dollar, I would say that this maker is really cool, and if you have the right ham size, I think my ham was a little bit too small. Excuses. I enjoyed making this. I think kids would love it. I'll definitely make these for Mr. Panda. I remember when I was a kid, I was so excited when my parents' friend made butterfly sandwiches. All it was cutting the sandwich into 4 triangles and sticking them together to make them look like butterflies. So I think kids would really like this. And it looks pretty easy to clean. I mean, just have a brush or something you can run through. And yeah, if you guys have other ideas for what you could put in your flour roll maker, let me know down below. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time. Bye!